somewhere in a safe part of India. And let us encourage all these people to go and live there. We must build something like a world-class township there. World-class township. And all the people should start speaking Sanskrit. Automatically the Sanskrit will become so easy and natural. ब्रह्मन् तथामि पृच्छामो धर्मान् भागवतां स्तव यान् श्रुत्वा श्रद्धया मर्त्यो मुच्यते सर्वतो भयाद्. In any way you have come to your house and you are seated, I am very happy. I am adoring you in the manner in which I know to adore. I am very happy. But though I have seen you and your very sight itself is ennobling, elevating and fulfilling, yet I have some question to ask you. What is that? Prachamo dharman bhagavatam stava. Listen to this word. I am asking you to enlighten me about bhagavata dharma. What? Bhagavata means a devotee. Bhagavata dharma means the character, behavior and interaction. The characteral, behavioral and interactional details of the devotees. Yan shrutva shraddhaya martyo. After listening to which description? Martyaha muchyade sarvado bhayad. If you narrate to me the Bhagavata dharmas and I am able to listen to you faithfully with attention, the very process of listening will liberate me. Muchyade sarvado bhayad. I will be completely liberated from the allfold fear that I am encircled by. So I want to be instructed, told about such Bhagavata dharmas. Then Vasudeva goes on saying, I made a great mistake. What? I made a? What is the mistake? I worshipped the Supreme Lord Vishnu. And he came before me, stood ready to give anything, including moksha. You know what I did? I asked him, be born as my son. And he was born as my son. He distributes liberation to everybody. Only a few houses the other way he sleeps. Vasudeva is living here and his Krishna is living. And you yourself have come because he is a bestower of liberation. So he distributes liberation to everybody. But I cannot get it because I feel he is my son. He was only born, but he was never bred by me. Because I told him be born. So he agreed to be born. You know, after getting born, what did he say? Take me immediately and leave me in Vrindavan. Bring the girl back. So I made a great mistake. My dear souls, never make this mistake. What? When you go and stand in front of the Lord, please don't stipulate what you want. Leave it to him. My dear God, you are omniscient. You are omnipresent. I have nothing to do except pray or except praise you, keep you in my heart. I am not going to say I want this, I do not want that. The decision is left to you. I am nobody to decide. You are the decider. You are the leader. You are the maker. You are the marer. You are the giver. You are the taker. So I completely resign myself before you. Never put up a list. Aham kila puranandam prajartho bhuvi muktidam abhujayam namokshaya mohito devamayaya. By virtue of a delusion that all people are suffering from, you know what I did? One part of it was right. I worshipped Lord Mahavishnu. After having worshipped him, he was present before me, ready to bestow any kind of a blessing, anything that is necessary, including liberation from the torments of the world. Abhujayam na mokshaya mohido devamayaya. But I never sought from him this liberation, that inner spiritual splendor, which will always be gracing me, with me, associated with me. I will be surrounded by that, penetrated by that. That kind of an inundation by the inner spiritual splendor, I never sought from him. That was the mistake. My son is very good. He is sought by a number of people. Even you have come to Dwaraka, not to see me, but to see my son and to be spending some time in worshipping him. So I have a submission. I am not perhaps the Vasudeva that people know about. My mind is really blazing with a number of torments. Yatha vichitra vyasanad bhavadbhir vishvato bhayad mucche mahyanjasaivadha tathana shyadi suvrata. I would like you to give me a beautiful instruction, as a result of which my mind can be appeased, my mind can be restful. It will also be in a position to have delight, rejoice, cheerfulness and contentment. From what? From where? Yatha vijitra vyasanad bhavadbhihi vishvato bhayad vijitra vyasanad. These are beautiful expressions of Srimad Bhagavatam. Particularly this particular Paramahamsa Samhita, vijitra vyasanad. This world, however much you may describe it, when it comes to be experienced in the mind level, can you tell me how much is the duration your mind is delighted, cheerful and ecstatic? And how much is the time the mind is suffering from one kind of tension, agitation or suffering itself? So the multi-pronged sufferings are there. Variously blended sufferings are there. People get married to think that family life is good. After children are born, they start growing up. Particularly after they grow up, they start suffering in the hands of their own children. Differences start cropping up. Even the best of love marriages, after some time, somebody comes and says, yes, this. Then I asked him, did you not marry in love? Yes, Swamiji, love was before marriage. But after marriage, when he started living together, we found all disparity, disharmony, conflict, confrontation. What can be done? I am ashamed to say this. Somebody was mentioning to me. So it's not as it looks. When it comes to the question of experiencing life in our mind, you will find it is suffering from a number of factors. Yatha vichitra vyasanad bhavadbhihi vishvato bhayad. The entire universe is now a forum of fear now. You know what is the fear that we are suffering from? Any one of you knows? We are heating up the earth. Global warming is taking place. The globe can be warmed up not by any other creature at all. The human population is very, very small compared to the mosquito population. So there are so many creatures in this world, 86 lakhs of kinds of creatures. All of them will not pollute the earth. They will not increase the global warmth. On the other hand, global warmth, they will not increase. So far as we are concerned, we can bring about any kind of a destruction. The global warmth has been tremendous, so tremendous, that at the end of this century, they say, we will have pushed the earth to a very strong precipitous, a dangerous precipitous. We don't know what is going to happen. And this has been brought about only by us. By the end of this century, the warmth will have increased by 2.5 degrees Celsius is what they say. It should be much less than 1 degree. This is the situation. So when we say vishvato bhayad, it's not enough if you have money, if you have a comfortable air-conditioned house, centrally heated one if necessary. But we must have a good air to breathe, a good water to drink, and very good healthy vegetables to eat, to digest. Now you can earn and you can have your money, but all these factors are never controllable by you. They are not depending upon you. So we are living as an individual, interacting with the entire world. Even our own individual personality is not under our control. The air we breathe is not ours. The water we drink is not ours. At the same time, we cannot avoid them. So it is actually vishvato bhayad. I find fear and fearfulness anywhere and everywhere throughout the world, he says. Mucche mahyanjasaivardha tatha nashyadi suvrata. How shall I be freed from this fear? So I would like to be told how to live a fear-free or a fearless life. It is true that my son is Lord Krishna to many of you. But for me, he is a son and I am a father. Maybe he is distributing liberation to a number of people, all kinds of people. But so far as I am concerned, his father, my mind is actually a kind of a furnace now. I would like you to give me instructions so that my mind will be cooled, comforted, appeased, and finally it will have the joy of contentment, exhilaration and ecstasy. Sri Suga Uvaja, राजन्नेवं कृतप्रश्नो वसुदेवेन धीमता प्रीतस्तमाह देवर्षिः हरे संस्मारितो गुणैः. See, when we decided to talk on Srimad Bhagavatam, it was my decision, our decision. I don't think it was your decision. Did any one of you want it? So generally, we would like to talk on the supreme reality, the supreme intelligence, the most auspicious God. I would like to describe him as Parama Kalyana Nidhihi. What? Say that. Parama Kalyana Nidhihi. He is a treasure of supreme felicity. This is Srimad Bhagavata's word. We are all devoted to God, but we don't understand him. We don't describe him. We say, frightening God, terrible God, devouring God, God who is inaccessible, who is at infinite distance. In this way, if you describe him, will you ever become fond of him? Why don't you describe him in the best of words, in the most appropriate manner? Parama Kalyana Nidhihi. This is the description of Lord Hari, the Supreme Lord of the world. That Parama Kalyana Nidhihi. We would like to speak about him. His exploits, his excellences, his beauty, his uniqueness, how charming he is, how safe it is to be in the company of Lord, how well he will protect us. Our parents may not be able to protect. Husband and wife may not be able to protect each other. Our friends also may become helpless. In all those conditions, the universal power and presence which protects the entire universe, the earth has been revolving in its own axis. It has been keeping a trajectory around the sun. For how many millennia earth has been doing this? Who is responsible for this consistency, this constantness? Are you following me? Who is responsible, you say? Even the buildings we are making are collapsing. But the earth has not collapsed so far. We are extracting so many things from the earth. The earth should be preserved. The greenery should be preserved. And we must be able to bequeath a better earth with a lot more of greenery to the succeeding generations. Are we doing it? We only to rob and dog. Should we not be able to evolve a method of life, a way of life, a nature of life, whereby whatever resources we utilize, those resources will not be depleted? Let us use the air, let us use the water, but never deplete the earth. That is the real intelligent way of living. Let us understand the rhythm of nature, the needs of nature, the pulsations of the nature, external as well as internal, gross as well as subtle. And let us live in tune with them, never in disharmony with all these things. So this is what we should understand. So God is always Parama Kalyana Nidhihi. So when Narada Maharshi has been coming to Dwaraka, at no time earlier, Vasudeva called him or invited him and finally made such a request. Now that you have submitted yourself, asking me to speak about Bhagavata Dharmas. Understand and remember this word. Bhagavata Dharmas. Bhagavan, you know. Bhagavata means the adjectival form of Bhagavan. Bhagavata Dharma means the characteristics, the behavioral and interactional traits, the type of thoughts, the type of speech, the type of actions which are characteristic of good devotees. You will find a better explanation later on. So you have asked me to tell you about Bhagavata Dharmas. Suddenly you know, Hare Samsmarido Gunaihi. By your question, I am reminded of the Supreme Lord Hari. Samsmarido Gunaihi. The qualities, the virtues and the excellences of the Supreme Lord, they come to me. They come to me. I am very happy that you have raised this question. He continues to say, Samyagedadvyavasidam bhavata sattvadarshabha yat prichase bhagavadan dharmam tvam vishwabhavanan. Samyagedadvyavasidam. He compliments Vasudeva. My dear Vasudeva, what you have done, you have done very well. I compliment you. I am very happy that you have raised this question. What have you raised? Bhavata sattva darshabha. You are yourself one of the most blessed devotees, at least according to our assessment. You may not feel it, but we all feel, having given birth to Lord Krishna, how much fortunate you should have been as a parent. This is what we feel. Yat prichase bhagavatan dharmam tvam vishvabhavanan. You chose to ask of me, inquire from me, the Bhagavata dharmas. What are these Bhagavata dharmas? Vishvabhavanan. Vishva, they are such that they will purify the entire universe. You know, when all of you are seated in this hall, I look at you and understand you as devotees of the Lord. And as a devotee, as long as devotion is there, filling your heart, filling your mind, filling all the cells of your body, you will find you are not merely purifying yourself, you are purifying the entire earth. Devotion is such a majestic, magnificent, and excellent undercurrent. Vishwa Bhavanan. So the Bhagavata dharmas are such that they are so sublime, so lofty, so beautiful, so holy, so austere, that they will purify the entire world. He describes them further. Listen to them very carefully. Suto anupatito dhyadaha adruto vanumodidaha. First of all, you happen to hear, go on hearing. After hearing, when you have had a little fondness and interest, start reading a copy of this Bhagavata Dharma, the Srimad Bhagavatam or the relevant portion. Dhyadaha. Then you start reflecting upon, ruminating upon what you have heard and what you have read. Adrudaha. Have respect, adoration. As you are worshipping God in your mind, you must have a worshipping attitude towards the Bhagavata dharmas, the characteristics and the behavioral patterns of lofty, enlightened devotees. Anumoditaha. Even when you are able to compliment, oh, Swamiji is discussing Srimad Bhagavatam, inner spiritual splendor, in the Chinmaya Mission auditorium for 5 days. Very good. At least have a sense of compliment about it. You need not come, but even then, try to help it if you can. At least tell a few people, at least know, oh, such good things are taking place in our country. It's very good, very nice. A sense of compliment and appreciation. Even this much is sufficient. When, then, sadhyaha, instantly, punadi saddharmo. This Bhagavata dharma has got such a potential, such a divine inner spiritual potential and splendor. If any one of these is done, what is that? Suto, anupatito, dhyataha, adruto, vanumoditaha, sadhyaha, punadi, saddharmo, deva vishvadruho hihi. Vishvadruho bihi. What does it mean? There are people who doubt and who are not happy about any kind of a belief. Rationalists are there, disbelievers are there. There are people who hate the devas and other divine agencies. Even such people will be purified by this Bhagavata dharma. Suto anupatito dhyadaha adruto vanumoditaha sadhyah punadi saddharmo deva vishvadruho bihi tvaya parama kalyanaha punya shravana kirtanaha. Are you hearing me? You know, whenever I read these words, you cannot imagine. I wish there is some kind of a barometer or a temperature reader which will be able to measure the joy I am having when I read these or recite these verses. Tvaya parama kalyanaha punya shravana kirtanaha smarido bhagavan adya devo narayano mama. By this inquiry, Vasudeva, do you know what you have done? You have brought in me, instilled in me, the memory of Lord Narayana. To think of Lord Narayana, we are after all mortals with a very limited body. And we have made a home. We were born in a home. We got married and settled ourselves perhaps in our own chosen home. With whom we are moving? Only with a few family members. Maybe you have a profession and you have a few professionals for also for you as your friends. This is a very, very, very micro relationship that you have. But what about the universe born and preserved by the Supreme Lord? Look at any direction. Can you see the end of sky? At night when the stars of the sky are visible, take a look. How many stars are there? Draw a little circle and count the number of stars there. What is this universe? This universe is one of which you are a son or a daughter. So as a human being, some time or the other, should we not have the expansiveness, the kind of a persuasion, the kind of an inspiration in our mind, whereby we will be able to think, oh my dear Lord, you have created a wonderful endless universe. I am a puny creature in that. Let me at least think about your greatness, your glory, the endless universe I see around. So what should be the infinite potential that you have in order to generate and preserve this kind of a stupendous universe? Don't you think such a thought is very rewarding? Huh? Why are you keeping quiet? Come out of your house. Look into the sky. Spend 15 minutes looking at the sky. That is the best divine meditation. Not looking at an idol. The idol is very small. Already small. It becomes smaller. This is a man-made idol. Now, God-made manifestations are there. Even in Srimad Bhagavata, when Krishna describes the process of meditation, you know what he says? Meditate upon the four-handed form of Mahavishnu, the Shuddha Sattva Murti. And when the whole form is sufficiently established in your mind, take away your vision, attention from all the lower parts and fix it on the smiling face. Are you following me? When Susmitam Bhavayen Mukham, that beautiful smiling radiant face, that alone you fix your attention inwardly by the mind. And when the mind is fixed there, what should you do? Take it away from that. Agrishya Vyom Nidhare. What? Engage it on the sky. Understand? You haven't heard, is it not? This is what devotional meditation is. Meditate upon your chosen deity and finally get to the smiling face. And thereafter take the mind away from the smiling face and engage it in the endless sky, the universe. This is how meditation is to be done. Now you have a mustard mind, my dear souls. A mustard mind. It is something like a very short diameter well. Make it at least a tank and a lake, preferably an ocean. And most desirably, it should be a spatial mind that you have. And man alone will be able to do it, not anybody else. Have you ever thought of a mental expansion like this? Our body completes its growth at the age of 21. The only constituents in our personality to grow are the mind and the intelligence. Mind grows by attitudes and bhavas. Intelligence grows by understanding. The understanding of the subject is far greater than the understanding of the object. Am I clear or not? The object is very limited by its nature, but the subject which perceives the object, in which all the objects are imprinted, are really the infinite and the endless. And within your body, you carry such an infinite dimension, the consciousness that you are.